Same here.
Okay, so you have no worries as long as, you know, it starts to come undone or anything like that. It won't mechanically, so you know that
okay.
It's safe.
Okay.
It looks so good.
Beautiful. It's good to see you.
Great talk.
Congratulations.
Thank you
very
much.
Does she have a practice bouquet?
A tossing bouquet.
That goes by the cake.
Okay. Perfect.
And I'm going to continue to bring bouquets up here if you'd like. Or if you'd like me to put them somewhere else, I can. I don't know where a best spot is for you.
I wonder if, well, do they stand like this? Do you have a way to stand them?
Well, they're all in
bruise.
Faces.
I would think on that table, do you see on the table in the hallway where they have...
Okay.
Oh, it's
okay.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Yes.
It's really pretty. I love how she incorporated.
That's true.
Yeah. I'm excited, and then I don't have to be worried about seeing him anymore either.
Yeah.
You know, like, he came away. It's like, okay, I saw him. It's all right. I really want to see this set up too, but I'll wait when we go up there.
For the courtyard?
Yeah.
Is Dave a crier?
He has been known to once in a while. Okay. Once in a while, but I don't think I think he's going to be happy today.
I didn't ruin it.
You what?
Just in a little
I didn't ruin it much when I drank. I drank the soda earlier.
Yeah. Yeah. Wait, get there. Get there.
Ah, there we go.
Awesome.
Thanks for grabbing me.
Never seen you with
something more normal.
Actually, maybe you want to introduce all the lovely ladies.
Oh, okay, sure. Yeah. So we'll start here. Sarah Werner, Dave's younger sister, all the way in from Virginia.
Cool.
She's entering school at George Mason this fall.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. guest. Next year is Kim Williams, best friend since preschool, and Kim and I go way back, clearly. Excellent fort maker and dancer. Julia Agostini, who was my roommate in Boston, did dance, lots of dancers here, did dance marathon with Julie in college, so she'll be out on the dance floor leading the way. Steph Wilson, who lived in my first year dorm in college, and is awesome, and an awesome California face bridesmaid, and Michelle Rose.
Hiding my door.
Friend from Girl Scouts in elementary school. Okay. She was married in Minnesota last summer, but she doesn't live there anymore. She's in New Mexico. So yeah, that's the group, and then the maid of honor.
Probably
coming
to
on her way up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dramatic entrance.
Yes, Amanda. She's coming. Miss Amanda Allen. Miss Amanda Allen married this past May. I want to call you Mandy Shinshaw. How was it down there? Did you see anything?
No, not yet. I mean, I looked over onto the foreground, but it looks gorgeous.
But it does. Okay, good.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, but no one's here yet. So we're good.
Okay, good.
I'm ready to see Dave.
That's what I'm thinking about.
A few minutes longer, I think.
Okay. And wait. I waited this long.
That's true.
Yeah.
Just a little bit better.
Okay, tell me, ladies. Smile from the big mirror.
You may.
Okay.
Perfect.
You gotta say it, Dave.
I know.
Why is it? Am I going too far? They just learned how to do this today. Steph taught them all.
No?
No. So you can remember again.
It's probably the hardest bridesmaid duty.
You mean
pink?
That makes sense.
There's three, right?
Thanks.
Yeah. That's good.
That makes more sense.
Very good.
Get that one.
Amanda, can you just deal with that one rebel piece of hair when you're done? Do you see it too? It's like this one rebel piece of hair.
Okay, you're gonna tell him when to turn, right?
Door on the right.
Yeah.
If you go third door, it's one. And you push. I went and knocked. No one came. I was like,
Okay, perfect. One. Okay. I still want to do that. Sure.
I got you right. Stick right here. Right back here, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you.
I believe we should all stand. I take it you haven't seen her today.
I see. I did it first of all. Yeah.
Who gives this woman in marriage to this man?
My wife and I.
Everyone that's not up here with me, may be seated. I'd like to welcome all of you here on behalf of April and Dave on this their wedded day. Can everyone hear me in the back? My voice carries well, and I've got a little help here anyway. Just as a personal note, I know several people are from St. Agnes Parish, and I just wanted to let you know that that was my home parish as a child, and I went to the parochial school there, so this having someone from St. Agnes is kind of especially meaningful for me. And now our first reader is Rick.
April and Dave, is it on? Is it all right?
No, okay.
April and Dave have chosen a work by Wilfred Peterson today. Well, I read it, and then I read it again, and then I realized how fortunate we are to be hearing these words today, not only for April and Dave, but all of us. And if everyone would just take this message that April and Dave have chosen for us, it's going to be a better world. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created, and in marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands, and it is remembering to say I love you at least once a day, and it is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with a honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world, and it is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and to forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. It is discovering what marriage can be at its best. Thank you, April and David.
He wanted to keep the mic, I see. Our next reading is a group production, Jen, Lindsay, and Scott.
This is a few words of wisdom from the great author, Dr. Seuss, in his book, Oh, the Places You'll Go. Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any way that you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. And you are the couple who will decide where to go. You'll look up and down streets, look them over with care. About some you will say, we don't choose to go there. With your heads full of brains and your shoes full of feet, you're too smart to go down any not so good street.
and you may not find any, excuse me, and you may not find any you'll want to go down. In that case, of course, you'll head straight out of town. It's opener there in the wide open air. Out there, things can happen and frequently do to people as brainy and footsie as you. And when things start to happen, don't worry and don't stew. Just go right along. You'll start happening too. Oh, the places you'll go, you'll be on your way up. You'll be seeing great sights. You'll join the high flyers and soar to great heights. You won't lag behind because you'll have all the speed. You'll pass the whole gang and you'll soon take the lead. Wherever you fly, you'll be best of the best. Wherever you go, you will top all the rest.
Except when you don't, because sometimes you won't. You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know, with so many strange birds as you go. So be sure when you step, step with great care and great tact, and remember that life's a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous and deft, and never mix up your right foot with your left. And you will succeed. Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. Kids, you'll move mountains. So be your name Buxbaum, Dowie or Bass, or Mordecai Alley Van Allen O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way.
And our third and final reading is to be read by me, and it's from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. This is why a man must leave father and mother, and the two become one body. They are no longer two, therefore, but one body. So then, what God has united, let none of us divide. The Gospel of the Lord. In a very, very few minutes, I can assure you, I think I learned this from an ancient pastor at St. Agnes Church, that the no souls are saved after the first 10 minutes of a Sunday homily. This is not a Sunday homily. But seriously, what April and Dave are about to do when they look into each other's eyes and not looking at me even though I'm speaking, and marrying each other and committing to each other, what are they really joining together? I mean, there's lots of, we have some beautiful, this is a beautiful place, this is a beautiful couple, the frills, everything's here. It's a real, as people would say, kind of a fantasy wedding. This is just beautiful. But what are they really doing below that in the quantum world? They're sharing in a very, very special way for the rest of their lives their life source, their life energy. And when we look around and see some of the beauties of nature in this valley here, and thank God for that tree, because we'd really be wiped out here. But the beauty of nature, that power that created all that is, and all that was and all that will be, is what you're sharing today with your life force. You know, when you go on your first walk as a married couple along the seashore and feel the spray of the ocean and the wind and the power of the sun, you're sharing in that same power. And just remember that, because this is significant. And when life throws its curves, which of course it will, that's when you want to remember what you created today with God. So yes, it's a very significant moment when you look into each other's eyes. And we all congratulate you, we pray with you, and we bless you. April and Dave, you've come together in this place of God's creation so that the Lord may strengthen and seal your love in the presence of me, the church's priest, and this community of your family and friends. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of this community of your family and friends, I ask you both to state your intentions. April and David, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Yes. Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? Since it is your intention to enter this marriage, you've already joined your hands, and now you're about to declare your consent before God and this community of your family and friends. And we'll begin with Dave.
I, David, take you, April.
I, David, take you, April.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and bad.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, April, take you, David.
I, April, take you, David.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You have now declared your consent before this community of your family and friends. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent, fill you both with his blessings, and again, let none of us divide what God has joined. And I'll ask for the rings, and I'm sure they're here. Okay, I'll just bless them first. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. And then Dave, you take April's ring. This finger. And over the knuckle, that's it. It's going over nicely. And hold hands and repeat after me.
April, take this ring.
April, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
That's gone over nice and tightly also. David, take this ring.
David, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And now we'll have the prayer of the faithful to be recited by Emily. Emily's up here. I think I started out with a brief prayer here. Now that we have heard God's word in the Bible and experienced the Lord's presence, in this exchange of vows, let us present these prayerful petitions for people in the world today.
And the response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For our Holy Father on earth, the Pope, all the bishops and clergy everywhere, that they may lead us to deeper faith in God and a stronger love for others, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our president and all leaders of government, that they may be effective in achieving peace and eliminating poverty, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married persons, that they may continue to give, be able to forgive, and find happiness deepen with the passing of each day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For April and Dave, now beginning their life together, that they may have divine assistance at every moment, the constant support of friends, the rich blessing of children, a warm love reaching out to others, and good health ripen to old age, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, lonely, discouraged, or oppressed, that they may be strengthened by God's help and aided by their friends, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially the relatives and friends of April and Dave, and of all present for this wedding, that they may enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment in eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these personal needs, which we mention now in silence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, by your power, you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning, you created the universe and made humankind in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman so that man and woman should no longer be two but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Look upon with love this woman April, your daughter, now joined to her husband Dave in marriage. She asked your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband Dave put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him to the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage. Give and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. and after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with all the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Now we'll have a final blessing over the couple. The Lord be with you all. Let us pray. May Almighty God, with his word of blessing, unite your hearts in the never-ending bond of pure love. Amen. May your children bring you happiness, and may your generous love for them be returned to you many times over. Amen. And may the peace of Christ live always in your hearts and in your home. May you have true friends to stand by you, both in joy and in sorrow. May you be ready and willing to help and comfort all who come to you in need. And may the blessings promised to the compassionate be yours in abundance. Amen. And may you find happiness and satisfaction in your work. May daily problems never cause you undue anxiety, nor the desire for earthly possessions dominate your lives. But may your heart's first desire be always the good things waiting for you in the life to come. Amen. And may the Lord bless you with many happy years together, so that you may enjoy the rewards of a good life. And after you have served him loyal in his kingdom on earth, may he welcome you to his eternal kingdom in heaven. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and remain with you, April, and with you, Dave, forever and ever. Amen. And now, it is my great privilege and pleasure to announce, for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Werner, and he may kiss the bride. Everybody stand.
Okay. Perfect. Perfect.
Okay. Ceremony site?
What?
The dress okay?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Do you want me to pick it up?
I think it's okay.
I think we're going to take some right down here, aren't we? Yeah, okay.
Okay, cool. We're just walking all the way around.
That's what I'm saying.
do that. Might as well.
Hi, April and Dave. We are so happy for you. So extremely happy for you. I cried. It was beautiful. It was really, really beautiful. So
congratulations, guys. Yeah. It was really wonderful.
We're so freaking happy for you. So, okay, so there's our well wishes. We're supposed to give some advice too. I don't know. Just, yeah, love each other as much as you can and forgive a lot and give each other space to be each other, to be yourself.
Yeah, I agree with all of that. And like the pastor was saying, it's two becoming one flesh, but remember that it's really important that you're still two individuals to give each other the flexibility and the patience and the space to explore that individuality. And that's going to make your marriage even stronger than it is when you're joined together. We are both thrilled that you met each other and found each other and got married. You guys are perfect for each other.
You're perfect for each other. So
happy for you. Congratulations, guys.
Always have fun in marriage. Always joke with each other. Just have fun. It's very, very important.
And always let the other person know, your spouse know, that he or she is the most important person in the world to you. And best wishes.
All right, so that whole spiel about never going to bed angry,
that doesn't work.
No,
it's okay. You'll fix it later, and it'll be just fine. You might just give a little squeeze of the finger or something to let it know it'll be okay, but you can stay mad at that. It's all right.
It'll work out.
It'll work out.
April and Dave, I plan to give you some more advice later after I've had a little bit more to drink, but for now, I would just like to say this has been a wonderful wedding so far. At least I haven't done anything yet to make you regret inviting me. And I hope you both have a fantastic wedding for the rest of your wedding day today and beyond.
Dave and April, congratulations on your wedding. This is so exciting and we're all so happy for you. My advice to you guys is keep having fun. Laugh all the time. Never go to bed angry. And always remember you guys are a team. So everything you do is for Team Dave and April. Cheers.
Just be happy and enjoy life and be fun and have babies so we can play with more babies.
Yeah. I guess what I would say to you is, have a great time, have lots of adventures together, make great meals together. That's a really important thing. Food will cement a lot of great memories. Travel, do it. And laugh a lot. Laugh as much as you can. That's really huge. And I think you guys do that already. So
this was a great wedding.
Fabulous.
Live like the wedding.
Okay.
April and Dave, it's Caroline and I. This is a very happy day for me because you guys can finally commensurate your marriage by making me no longer a bastard child and you can legally adopt me, which makes me very, very happy. So here's to you and many, many more years of scandal. I love you both.
Hey, April and Dave. Of course, you know me as well. April, I'm sure that we would have met one way or another with our 5 degrees of separation between Nils, Aaron Weber, who else? Candace and Emily, Omar, I don't even know who else. Dave, I don't know if you knew this, but I'd actually seen your portfolio before we met. I was quite impressed. You're one of the most creative people I know. Couldn't be happier for the two of you, and I wish you many adventures in the days to come.
So, April and Dave, I don't have much advice because, as you know, Omar and I are married only 2 months now, but we were watching our wedding video the other day, and we were loving the advice and the stories that people had given us on video. So I definitely have to talk about the day that I met you guys, and we went to Visa Tui. So we were here just about a year ago or so, in July 2009, and we went wine tasting, and I just kind of loved you guys from the beginning, and it was just a kind of a fast friendship from there with me, and Omar and I have really enjoyed getting to know you guys throughout the last year. I'm planning a wedding together, so thank you for that time.
Recording from Visa.
I know, this is a crazy microphone, and we look forward to many more happy memories, and just congratulations. I love the ceremony. I love today, and we love you guys.
This is Omar Garriott reporting from Visa Tui Live. I just wanted to say congratulations. A beautiful, beautiful ceremony, beautiful venue, beautiful bride and groom. I just want to tell a quick story. So the really kind of composed, tearful Dave just now, you know, the super nice guy that we all know and love. We saw a different side of Dave a couple weeks ago. I think he was trying to get rid of some wedding stress, wedding planning stress. But we went and did karaoke late night. And Dave, suffice to say, he's got a little bit of a tough side. He knows all the lyrics to most rap songs, and it was pretty shocking. He also knows how to turn his hat sideways and kind of scare you, but actually very talented, very talented. And we're just so happy for you guys. This was absolutely beautiful. So congratulations, and I'm gonna send it back to the studio.
Wilson and Jinsu Rowe. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Kim Williams and Don Simpson. And Mandy Allen and Andrew Werner. Thank you. dance floor. It's now time for April and Dave's first dance as a married couple.
What you need and we disappear. Without a trace, we'll be gone. The moon and the stars will follow the calm. And then when we get to the ocean, we're gonna take a boat to the end of the world. All the way to the end of the world.
Terrific dance, wasn't it? I mean, it was just amazing. Very good, very good. My name is Bob Shimshock. I'm the father of the bride, and I'm also now the father of a new son. I have three sons now. Not only, I started with one, I had two in May 15th. Now I have three. I'm very happy about all that. I'm very happy to welcome all of you here on behalf of the Warner and Shimshock families to this very special occasion. Truly makes us all happy that you are here to spend the time with us. I know it's a busy time of the year, a lot of commitments, 4th of July today, holiday weekend, and to take this time and spend it with us, and you've all helped us a lot in preparing for this day. Today's ceremony performed here outside in the courtyard was just beautiful. I mean, this country up here, I think we have to all admit, is amazing. Father Tom, wherever you are, outstanding job. The readings were just tremendous today. I think, Jen, Lindsay, Scott, Nick, and Emily all did fantastic jobs reading, and I really enjoyed it all. And it brought together a lot of thoughts I think we should all share on a daily basis of love and caring for one another. And I think it's so important this time of the year and any time of the year because of so many things going on in the world. And I think bringing two people like this together is just a wonderful occasion for all of us. One thing I'd like to say
You know, this setting out here and everything, it reminds me of a Hollywood movie. You know, what happens is a young guy goes out in the world, he's successful, he shows a lot of caring for a young lady. On the other side, the woman shows affection for her new man that she has met. And what happens is they grow together and they become partners. And what happens is I could see the love in their faces up there. And it's just very much like a Hollywood movie. And it reminds me of the fact that, you know, we're all just actors around different sets of a Hollywood movie wherein people are all participating. Like, I'd like to really thank some of the people that have made this day possible. First of all, the maid of honor, one of my other daughters, Amanda, who is the bridemaid and sister of April, and she was also the planner of the East Coast Marathon Shower. It went on for days and days. And then also wherever Andrew is, Andrew was the orchestrator of the Lake Tahoe adventure. And I think it's what's Dave's Lost last weekend or something like that, where you really had a great time out there. And then also, of course, Dave's parents, Chris, Elizabeth, my wife, Terry, and all many of you people out here that helped to make this day what it is. Let me jump ahead a little bit here. What I really think of at times is I'm an older guy now, and I think about some of the people I've met along my day's experience. And one of the guys I work with right now is a young guy. Scott Allen knows him. He's only 26 years old, like many of you young people here. And he says, "Bob, you have a story about everything." He said, or some saying or something like that. And I said, "Well, I guess with getting older." I said, "You learn about people, you learn some things." And I think there are some things that are very valuable to remember. What you have to do really with your life is you have to learn that you have to respect others. You have to make the most of your life. You have to enjoy what you're doing. That's very critical. And you have to try to learn as much as possible as you go along. After that, my own life, it seems like things sort of sort themselves out. A friend of mine who's a model, who I worked with for many years, said to me, "It's important that we all contribute. Time is not reversible. You cannot go back. You have to move forward and succeed. Be happy. Life is short, and young and old can tell us a lot about living." April and Dave, I think, are two very good examples. They've done so much in their short lives already, and there's so many things that they will be doing in the future together as husband and wife. And I believe they really, really demonstrate those traits of respect and honor. And also, most importantly probably too, is they're doers. They go out and it's real action whenever they're moving around together. Chris and Elizabeth, Dave's mom and dad, I think they've really done a remarkable job in raising Dave. What I found is you don't wake up one day and just say, "My son should be." What you really have to do is you have to teach them the traits of respect, hard work, and learning. And I believe they've done an outstanding job. And I'd just like to say thank you very much for all you've done. Dave, because of their upbringing, Dave has done an exceptional job in his life thus far. He did very well at Robinson High School, where April and Dave met. Then he moved on to UVA as an English music major, which is very important. Master's of Design, he made his master's at the Design Portfolio Center in Atlanta, and now he's working with Minor Studios here in San Francisco. First time I really met Dave was at UVA Dance Marathon. And as I mentioned to somebody here, actually, he was behind bars at that time. But it was a good bars, because they had this like little thing where you had to go in as part of the dance marathon. And we still have that in our photo album. He's behind these bars holding on to it. But, you know, whenever I first met Dave at that time, I could tell that he was a very, very nice person. He was very sincere. Bobby was just a young fellow at that time. He took him under wing, and he was ushering him around. And I said, here's a really nice guy. And, you know, that's very important to show, you know, just kindness to one another. We were really happy whenever, as years passed, really, April talked more about Dave. And it seemed like they were getting much closer. The relationship was getting more serious. All the time, Terry and I were very happy that she could find someone so nice in this world. And April then grew to talk more and more about him. And then April was very excited to be here in San Francisco. They spent a lot of great times here traveling around and doing great things together. Then all of a sudden, I get this call from San Francisco. And it says, some young man says, could I ask April to marry me? And it means a lot to a father. It really does, because I think in this day and age, you don't have people that come out and ask that. And I've been very fortunate. I have two of those. I have Scott and I have Dave, both very nice young gentlemen. And parents obviously did an outstanding job in raising them. April has always given her all in everything she's done throughout her life. I recall her trying out for cheerleading and making it with Kim, who's around here someplace. And Stacy and Mandy would try and practice a lot downstairs. She did that. She did very well at Robinson High School along with Dave. At UVA, she was at McIntyre School of Commerce. She went up to Boston, met more new friends, expanded more her relationships. Then she went on to Goldman. She worked at Goldman Sachs. She worked at American Capital, where she is right now, also in San Francisco, which is really good. Other thing I always remember about April is her sharing. With Mandy, is her sister, snacks, experiences. She took her to New York. She had her in Charlottesville. They went to San Francisco to go together. They were truly great companions for one another. Also, being one of two great big sisters to Bobby. Caring for him, teaching about school and life, sharing her time with him, no matter how busy. And she is a busy young lady, as I think we all know. She also was very good to Terry and to me, wherein she shared and made us very proud of her as she grew older. All of her accomplishments, her successes, and she constantly talked with us about it. She shared with us, which is very important to parents. Well, we all know how conscientious April is. She makes the list, she checks it twice, and then she does every step. Well, one time I very distinctly remember, she didn't follow a plan. What happened is it was a Sunday afternoon, and she liked to do well in school, obviously, as she does right now. And so it was Sunday afternoon, and she said, well, I need a textbook at school at Robinson. Robinson is a very big school in Northern Virginia. And I said, well, and she said, well, we got to go and get it or something like that. And I said, well, the school is locked. And she said, well, we got to get this textbook. I'm going to have an exam tomorrow. Well, okay, I got involved. And I think many of you have gotten involved in her plans. Maybe some being planned well, some maybe not so well. Well, this one wasn't planned. So we get to Robinson, it's a big school, and we go around the whole perimeter of the school, all the doors are locked, we finally find one that's open. We get inside the school, there's chain link fences down. We couldn't get it around. Well, April had to have this book, so we keep on scoping around a bit, and then we get in past the chain links, we get to the locker bay, we finally get the textbook, get the textbook, we're moving past the chain links, we get through the gym, and hey, we're out of here, we made it. And so, for some reason, we had to go through the football field, the running track, and then, all of a sudden, I hear somebody shouting in the back. He says, stop, wait, whatever, you know. And I said, Dave, I said, keep on walking, just walk slow, don't do anything at all, don't look back. But this guy is persistent. He keeps on yelling. So finally, I turn around and look up. It's a security guard. Well, in the Hollywood way, Bonnie and Claude were busted. We were just ending right there. Well, the security guard says to me, he says, well, you know what you did wrong? I knew exactly what I did wrong. I followed somebody who didn't have a plan. So, one thing I'd like to say about that is, I think what we've seen today, April and Dave made the first step of a plan. And we were all witness to that. And I think that as we move through, we'll see that each day they'll be taking other additional steps. And what we have to recall is the fact of a Hollywood movie. You have two main characters who are moving along. You have others that are cameo appearances. We will still be involved in our lives, but they will be the principal actors as they go through life. And we will be still involved with them, I know. At this time, I would like to now make a toast to two wonderful people. To April and Dave Warner. And I'm going to get the strike. May your life together be full, and may you enjoy every minute as much as we have enjoyed spending those minutes with you. Thank you both very much.
Hello, everyone. sister and the maid of honor, and wanted to give my toast now. First off, I did, like my dad did as well, I wanted to thank you all for coming. I know it really has meant so much to April and Dave to come and celebrate their marriage. I know a lot of you made a long trip, and they really appreciate it. Also, I'd like to thank the couple and both sets of parents for putting together such a lovely weekend. I know everyone has had an amazing time so far. So I'd like to talk a little bit about April first. As most of you already know, she truly is one of the most caring and loving people you ever meet. And actually, one of my favorite pictures from childhood depicts this really well. She was probably about 7 or 8, and I was 2 or 3, and it was actually on Halloween. And so she was dressed up as this cute, adorable nurse. And next to me, I'm quite a lot shorter at this period in time. And I'm kind of her mummified bandage patient. And it was an adorable picture nonetheless. But it really has just depicted so much about what April has done for me throughout the years. She's taken such good care of me. And she's done it for me, our family, and really just everyone who's fortunate enough to call her their friend. This is just one of the reasons that April's truly the best sister and best friend I could have. There are so many reasons. To be honest, you know, I could tell you them and we'd be here all night. But you can see they put quite a lot of effort into planning everything, so I'll just sum it up a little bit. She really is supportive, funny, outgoing, loving, beautiful, and just all around amazing. You know, as we've grown up, we've done so many things together. She's helped me to build forts. We've learned cheerleading. Well, I should say she taught me cheerleading after she had learned it. Edited my college applications, and then we just explored cities together that were her home at the time, but I had never seen before. I knew it was amazing. As most of you know, I did get married recently, and we both planned vineyard weddings together. And over the past year, I mean, I really can't think of anyone else that I would have wanted to share this experience with. Even across the country, we've planned the weddings together. It's been amazing. She did move across the country, you know, to be with Dave. And we've formed such a close bond throughout the years, and sometimes you get worried that when people move far away, you're going to lose that. And so I kind of have a cute story just to tell how much that we are still on similar wavelengths together. It was about a month ago. And she was getting ready for her trip back east for her bridal shower and bachelorette, so I was just calling to check in, you know, see that she was getting all ready. And she was like, well, you know, I have, you know, to have a minute, I'm in a dressing room. And it was actually a store I'd just been in that afternoon. And she's like, I might have found a dress that I was going to wear for my bridal shower. And so she started describing it to me, and she's like, yeah, the bottoms is bright yellow. At that point, I interrupted her. And from across the country, I described the entire rest of the dress she was wearing right then. Because I purchased it that afternoon from across the country for her bridal shower. So, of course, she did end up wearing the style of this for her bridal shower as the bride. But it really just shows how close we still are. Then there's also her amazing counterpart, Dave. And I haven't known him for as long, but he's a great guy. I truly know he's a perfect one for April. And really what stood out to me is his creativity and his passion for his career, his personal life, but also above all else, the creativity he shows with April, the creativity he shows in his love and adoration for April. And I mean, just looking around, you can see so much of that throughout the ceremony, that he's put in a lot of hard work, and I truly appreciate that. He takes good care of her. And then April and Davis couple, I mean, they really are a perfect match. I'm sure you all have seen that today alone, and you've seen it throughout their relationship as well. I really loved hearing about it, too. I mean, from creating a band in the video game Rock Band together, or from exploring the vineyards out here, or to going to the Snoopy theme park, I just love hearing about their adventures together. Especially Snoopy. As a younger sister, it might not be my place to give too much advice for them for their marriage, but to be honest, I don't feel they need it. I mean, this is a couple that I've seen have so much fun together, but they've also really known how to support each other through the rough times, and that's what counts. So, I'd like to wish the best of luck to my sister and my new brother. I can't wait for all the further adventures to have with you, or to hear about as well. I love you both, and so cheers to the beautiful couple, April and Dave. Love you both.
Well, good evening. For those of you who don't know me, good evening. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Andrew. I'm Dave's brother, younger brother. And it's great to see so many people who came from near and far to be part of such a special day. I want to thank April's parents, Bob and Terry, and my parents, and Dave's parents also, Chris and Liz, for hosting such a fantastic weekend and really for raising such great kids. That's not to say that Dave and I never got in any trouble when we were younger. Our mom would always know that Dave and I were up to something if it got too quiet. That was always the telltale sign. Before Dave could even talk, he showed me how to climb out of the playpen, which I'm sure my mom enjoyed. When we were watching Mr. Rogers once, Mr. Rogers showed us what was in his fridge. He had two or three things, some eggs, some milk, that sort of stuff. So Dave and I decided to unload the entire contents of our refrigerator on the couch in front of the television. And we only got a little bit of Cool Whip. That was it. So we were pretty good. We drew weather maps on the walls in crayon and magic markers so many times that our parents just gave up on painting over them each time. So April, if it ever seems too quiet in the house, just go and check on Dave. He might be drawing on the walls or unloading the refrigerator in front of the television. And you've heard it before, and you guys have all had the chance to see it. Dave's by and far the most creative person I know. That made growing up with him a constant adventure. We made up a company, DAA, which stood for David and Andrew, which later became DAS, David and Sarah, or David, Andrew, and Sarah. I was there too when Sarah was born. And we would put this, we'd brand all of our elementary school products. Dave actually went so far, he would put trademark and copyright information on his. He didn't want any unauthorized duplication of book reports on Goodnight Moon, I suppose. Dave's also been making music since we got a Fisher-Price tape recorder in Christmas in the early 80s. We played in the band, along with two of the other groomsmen during middle school, high school, college. And maybe a little bit later tonight, you might get to hear some of Dave's musical ability. And if you ask nicely. And so now Dave makes video games for a living, which is absolutely perfect, because some of you might know this. He had two letters published in very prestigious video game magazines in 1994 and easily made him the coolest kid in eighth grade. And so, April, it's fantastic that you don't just tolerate video games, but that you actively enjoy them. And it really frustrates me to no end that you're a much better drummer in Rock Band than I am. That's aggravating. And I think that's the great thing about this relationship, that Dave and April are both such kids at heart. I mean, he used a treasure hunt to propose. She makes those ice cream cone cupcakes. They go on road trips to Disneyland and tapings of So You Think You Can Dance. And yesterday, if you asked Dave what the greatest day of his life was, I guarantee you I could tell you what it was. It was mid-late 80s. We got to have Pizza Hut and Mountain Dew for dinner, which was an exceptionally rare treat. And then we got home and we played our brand new Atari game all night long, probably because there's no way you could get us to bed after having that much soda. And while that still sounds pretty amazing, I'm sure that tomorrow Dave will have a very different answer. So, April, you make him happier than I've ever seen him, and the two of you are a perfect fit. So here's to a lifetime of love and happiness for Dave and April. Cheers.
My name is Jinsu Ro, and as some of you may know, Dave and I were sweetmates in college. And so I thought I should say something this evening, and I was looking through a scrapbook that I had prepared of my college years, something I suppose college grads with nothing to do really end up doing. And as I thumbed through page after page of photos of Dave and me and various shenanigans, nothing really struck me But then out of the corner of my eye, I saw a list of 47 names. Now, little known fact, I served on the lawn selection committee my last year at UVA. And it was a group of people who looked through applications and decided who would have the honor and privilege of living on Mr. Jefferson's fabled lawn of his academic village the following year. And I had kept this list of 47 names we had chosen, I suppose in the hope that one day I would say, you know, I knew that person way back when. Well, it just so happens April Shimshock was on that list. And come to think of it, I remember April's application. Now, the applications, they were blind, so we didn't know the names, but we did see their resumes and their essays. And what struck me about April's application was Dance Marathon. And I thought, well, I don't know this person, but I know Dance Marathon because of Dave. Dave would have people in his room strategizing and planning and drawing out things for Dance Marathon. And so I figured, well, if this person's involved in Dance Marathon, then they must be qualified to live on the lawn. So what does all this prove? That what's trite is true. The world sometimes works in mysterious ways. And in that spirit, some words I'd like to share, inscribed on a sundial at UVA. Time is too slow for those who wait, too swift for those who fear, too long for those who grieve, too short for those who rejoice. But for those who love, time is eternity. Hours fly, flowers die. New days, new ways pass by. Love stays. April, Dave, may you always have love.
Makes me happy. sunshine in my eyes can make me cry. Sunshine on the water looks so lovely. Almost always makes me high. If I had a day that I could give you, I'd give to you a day just like today. If I had a song that I could sing for you, I'd sing a song to make you feel this way.
Ladies and gentlemen, give all our parents a big hand. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to invite everybody up the stairs for the fireworks we'll be playing. And there's also wine on the second level to grab on your way up. Gentlemen, might get your camera handy, and our bride and groom are now cutting the cake. Doing that thing you do.
Ladies, here we go. First of all, we got all our single ladies. Ladies, put your hands up, act like you want it. Here we go. On the count of three. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, next we need all the single gentlemen. Single men, don't be shy. Single men, please step up. On the count of three. One, two, three.
Well, I'd like to visit the moon on a rocket ship high in the air. Yeah, I'd like to visit the moon, but I don't think I'd want to live there. I would love to look down at the earth from above. I would miss all the places in April I love. So although I may go there for one afternoon, I don't want to live on the moon. I'd like to travel under the sea. I could meet all the fish everywhere. Yes, I travel under the sea, but I don't think I'd want to live there. I could stay for a day if I had my wish, but there's not much to do when your friends are all fish. And an oyster and clam are dinosaur. There's so many strange places I'd like to be, but none of them permanently. See that I'm the one who understands you. Been can't you see? You belong.
to me. He, you belong to. Stop calling, stop calling. I don't want to talk anymore. There's a heart in my heart on the dance floor. You can call all you want, but I won't pick up. And I'm not going to reach my telephone. Sail on a moonbeam and then I would make a wish on a star. And then I'd be home once again. I would love to look down at the earth from above. I would miss all the places and people I love. So although I may go there,
gentlemen, give Dave another big hand.
Let's
ladies and gentlemen, before we get out of here, we got another song. I want everybody to turn to somebody and just give them a hug and say, it's good to see you. I love you. Go around and hug somebody. Say, this is just beautiful to see you. Show some love. Show some love. Not too much love, just a little love.
Open all the doors and let
gentlemen, please give yourselves and our bride and groom a big hand. Hope everybody enjoyed.
Oh, why didn't you do an interview?
I love you. Happy wedding. Best of luck. I'll see you soon.
Oh, I got your camera. Beautiful.
Thank you.